Hi and welcome to a new video here on my channel, and this time I'm really happy again that I can present one of my new products to you. And today it's the Intel 9th Gen OC frame, which I designed for 9600K, 9700K, 9900K CPUs in order to have them capable of direct die. So why would you even go for direct die, or what does direct die mean? You can see it on here. I mounted one CPU, for example, so it means that we remove the heat spreader of the stock CPU, get rid of one additional layer of thermal paste or of the heat spreader itself. Therefore, we can reduce the temperature of the CPU by mounting the CPU cooler directly on top of the chip. On the previous CPUs like 8700K, it was not possible to do direct die because the CPU core was typically sitting lower than the CPU socket itself, so the plastic part of the socket. Therefore, if you tried to mount your CPU cooler directly on the die, it would not have perfect contact. Typically, the CPU would not even power up because you're lacking pressure to push the CPU inside the socket. But with 9900K, if you followed my launch video where I showed the first deleting of the CPU, I showed also that the CPU has a much thicker PCB than 8700K. Also, the chip itself is thicker, which means that in the result, the chip is sitting a lot higher now in the socket, which means we can do direct die again and achieve lower temperatures. This said, the 9th gen OC frame is not compatible with any other CPUs than 9600K, 9700K or 9900K. The following non-K CPUs should be compatible with it, but for example, 8700K is absolutely not compatible. You should not try it because your CPU cooler will not have contact to the chip and you might kill your CPU, so don't attempt mounting this OC frame on anything else than 9600K, 9700K or 9900K. The OC frame is made out of CNC milled aluminium, which is then black anodized, and anodized means that it's not electrically conductive as long as you don't scratch the surface, which also protects the OC frame from liquid metal, for example, because if you would apply it directly to naked aluminium, if it would not be anodized, yeah, you would just kill your OC frame because the gallium inside the liquid metal would eat up the OC frame. That's why it's anodized. The OC frame comes in this typical black box, which I always use for my products. It comes with a Torx screwdriver, which is necessary to mount the OC frame because we will use the stock Intel screws, which are mounted on top here and one is on the bottom. The reason for that is that we want to use the stock backplate of the mainboard, which allows us to save costs, which allows us to have the product cheaper for you. Talking about the price, it should be available at around 30 euro for you, and we're also working to have it available worldwide. Mounting the OC frame in general is pretty easy because you just have to tighten three screws. But in order to have the CPU possible for direct die cooling, we have to delete the CPU first. And the 9900K, 9700K, 9600K are all soldered. They use the Intel solder TIM, which you can see on the backside of this IHS. So we have to delete the CPU first. You can use a Delete Die Mate 2, for example, for normal deleting. We did it on many, many CPUs at Case King. We did not kill any CPUs while deleting them with the Delete Die Mate 2, so you don't have to be afraid. But I can understand if you would say that the risk for you would be too high to delete your own 9900K. In this case, we decided from Case King's side that we are offering the CPUs already without heat spreader. So you can buy a bundle of the OC frame and a 9900K already deleted and prepared for direct die cooling. So if you want to get this bundle, you can also find it in the description at the Case King shop. Just check down the description in the YouTube video. So if you decided that you want to go for direct die cooling and you want to use it with your own 9900K, for example, you have a Delete Die Mate 2 and you decided to go for deleting, what is really important is that you're really careful with the knife while scratching off the Intel TIM. So the TIM is indium, which is really soft. You can scratch it off with a knife. That's what I always do. I just take a cutter knife, a smaller piece of it, and then carefully scratch off the indium. Just be aware and be really careful that you don't go over the edge directly. You should use a round motion across the edge to be sure that you don't break off the edges, because that's something I've seen before. If you just go directly over the edge, you can break the edge of the CPU die and therefore maybe kill your CPU. So be really careful when you do that. Once you removed the solder TIM, you're pretty much ready to go. You only have to remove all the glue residues from the PCB and then you can put the CPU inside the mainboard socket. Put the OC frame on top and start tightening the three screws. Just make sure that you only tighten each screw a little bit each time and don't tighten one screw directly by 100% and then move over to the next one. That would be quite bad. Once you've done that, you're pretty much ready to go. Only apply liquid metal. That's what I would advise you to do. Otherwise, it doesn't really make much sense, because if you go for direct die, you would want to have the best temperature possible. And in this case, you would always go for liquid metal. Then there is always the question, which CPU cooler is actually compatible? I tried the EK Supremacy Evo and I tried the new product from EK, which should be the Velocity. Both of them worked fine without any issues. So you have those screws that come with it, which you screw inside the backplate to mount it on the mainboard, and then you can just mount your CPU cooler. Always worked fine for me. In case you have any kind of temperature performance problems, I would advise that you get longer M4 screws. Like this one should be M4 times 50, and then you can cut it to whatever length you need to adjust it to your CPU cooler, because some of the CPU coolers, they're not capable in adjusting the height where they are mounted. Because if we go for direct die, you have to keep in mind that we lose the height of the heat spreader. So typically we lose about 2 millimeters, which we need to mount the CPU cooler lower. So especially a lot of the air coolers, they're limited in height. You cannot really mount them lower. But for the typical custom water cooling equipment like the EK Supremacy Evo or Heat Killer stuff, Aqua Computer, most of them allow that you can lower them at the height, or you just replace the screws and you should be fine. When it comes to Acetec AIOs like the Corsair or NZXT Kraken, it's pretty easy to mount them as well if you replace the stock mounting stuff by just longer M3 screws. Then it should also be no problem to do direct die cooling with the Acetec based AIOs. Performance wise, it seems to really depend on the CPU. I tested some CPUs that benefited like 9 to 10 degrees Celsius lower temperatures, going from just liquid metal on the CPU to direct die with the CPU and also liquid metal. But I also had CPU cases, especially 9600K, where it was only about 4 or 5 degrees or even 3 to 4 degrees. So be aware that the temperature benefit really depends on your CPU. But typically, I would expect something between 4 and 10 degrees temperature improvement. So if you have any kind of questions about the OC frame, just put it down in the comments. I will try my best to answer them. See you soon.